Hey guys, my name is Erin Langley and I'm a senior biology major at Arkansas State. Today I'm going to talk to you about my cultural heritage food project in which I'm making pumpkin chocolate chip cookies. Andrew Smith, a professor of food studies in New York City, said about community cookbooks, you get an insight into history that isn't there from any other source. It's just not in newspapers, it just hasn't survived. Historically, community cookbooks have been used for fundraisers, as political pamphlets, and to record community history. Religious groups in particular use community cookbooks in order to fundraise. Modern church cookbooks have been adapted to include web recipe forms and have also been adapted to include dairy-free and gluten-free products. The trend today, overall, as you can see on Pinterest, is to include personal stories with your recipes. Before we talk about the origin of my personal recipe, I'd like to tell you a little bit about the origin of pumpkins. The pumpkins originated with the Native Americans before they were passed along to the colonists. They originally used them as a food source, they used the seeds as medicine, they made pumpkin flour, and they even dried out pumpkin shells and made bowls and containers. Today, in modern society, we use pumpkins in recipes for pie, pancakes, as pumpkin seeds, in soup, and in this recipe, cookies. So why does this recipe matter to me? So for my personal family, this recipe originated at the Easton Wesleyan Church in Easton, Maine. My great aunt's best friend posts this in their community church cookbook, and then she ended up passing it to my grandma, who then passed it to my mother, and then to my sister and I. And what you'll see later in this video is my new niece. She is learning to cook, and I have no doubt that this will eventually become part of her own personal cookbook. So this particular recipe actually isn't hard to make, but it is an amazing recipe. Some of the key ingredients in this recipe are pumpkin, of course, sugar, eggs, flour, and chocolate chips. This recipe is made by combining all of the wet ingredients into one bowl, all of the dry ingredients into another, and then just mixing them all together, and then baking them for 8 to 10 minutes at 375 degrees Fahrenheit. There's so many. This is the best part. Ah! I really hope that you enjoy this recipe. It's one of my personal favorites. Now, we're going to go to the cooking show featuring the future chef of America, Miss Zoe Carver. What do you want me to do?
A word.
You want me to cook?
Cook you, me, show me.
Blow him a kiss. Zoe.
Cook you me.
Oh, okay. We're not ready to go. We're ready to cook some more. Hey, bye-bye.